Apple buys an AI company. Facebook Messenger just cannot be stopped. Human-sized drones show up at CES and more. It's Thursday, January 7th, and this is Crunch Report. Hey everybody, welcome to CES again. I'm still here, I'm still standing. Apple's making more moves in the artificial intelligence space and has acquired EMOTIENT, which is an AI startup based in San Diego, California. EMOTIENT, which calls itself the leader in emotion detection and sentiment analysis based on facial expressions, has been around since 2012 and has raised about $8 million to experiment with products like Google Glass and other wearables. In its report about the sale, the Wall Street Journal also says that EMOTIENT was recently working with advertisers to bake in reaction analysis into their advertising. Apple confirmed the acquisition but gave us its usual boilerplate response, quote, Apple buys smaller technology companies from time to time, and we generally do not discuss our purpose or plans. Thanks for that, Apple. Facebook Messenger now has 800 million monthly active users, which is up from 700 million in June, and that's up from 600 million in March, and that was up from 500 million back in November of 2014, so it's growing. You know what that also makes Messenger? The fastest growing app of 2015, that's according to Nielsen, and the second most popular iOS app behind Facebook itself. Messenger is also now transmitting 10 billion photos per month, and the team is pretty pleased with themselves. In a blog post today, head of Messenger, David Marcus, laid out the app's 2016 strategy, including replacing the phone number, getting people to think that way, increasing video messaging, getting folks used to texting customer service, and of course, the chatbot platform that we told you about yesterday. I've been at CES long enough now to start losing my voice and also get pretty burned out on drones. There are a lot of drones here. However, I cannot help myself with this one. It's EHANG'S 184 drone, which is unique because it's human-sized. Yeah, it fits an actual human inside the drone. EHANG, which is a Chinese company founded in 2014, has raised about $50 million in venture funding and is confident that the 184 is the future of personal transport. The drone is about 4.5 feet tall, it weighs 440 pounds, and should be able to carry a single passenger for 23 minutes at a speed of 60 miles per hour, if it actually comes to market, which is iffy, like a lot of cool things at CES year after year. The 184 also has gull wing doors and arms that fold up, and EHANG says flight will be totally automated, meaning passengers input a destination, and then they have no more control during the entire flight. Now, if that sounds terrifying to you, the company says fail-safe systems include multiple backups for each flight and a feature where the drone will immediately land if a passenger's life is at risk. Let's hope that part works. Samsung is the world's biggest maker of Android devices. You kind of think Android when you think of Samsung Mobile. However, here at CES today, the company announced it'll be working with Microsoft to develop the Internet of Things or IoT devices based on Windows 10. The two companies say they'll work together to develop products that will run on the platform and also integrate with other companies developing hardware and services for Windows 10. Samsung and Microsoft actually have a history of working together 30 years about on Windows devices, but when it comes to mobile, Google's Android and, of course, Apple's iOS have pretty much run away with the market. Although, TechCrunch has been hearing of tensions between Samsung and Google over Android for some time now. We don't really have a ton of details about this Microsoft partnership, not yet anyway, but Microsoft does want to develop more universal Windows apps that work across different devices with that single unified security system in place, and in the announcement pointed to Samsung's Tab Pro S as a shining example. Do you like to grill things on a grill? If you're a human, the answer is probably yes. But do you also like to clean that grill? Probably not, because cleaning grills kind of sucks. Who wants to do that? That's why you might love GRILLBOT. It's the robot that cleans your grill for you. Very appropriate name. That's all it does. It's a Roomba for grills. It costs $129 and has three replaceable metal bristles that help the robot clean and also move around. It also has a rechargeable battery, three electric motors, and an LCD alarm and timer so you don't have to babysit the process. However, your grill has to hit a temperature of about 200 degrees before you can start the cleaner. So you can't do it immediately after making dinner. It needs to cool down for some time. And it's probably not going to be exactly as efficient as just rolling up your sleeves and doing it yourself. But you don't like doing that anyway. Remember, we established that earlier. Help the GRILLBOT help you. And that is the report for today. This episode of Crunch Report was brought to you by Go90. I'm Sarah Lane. Thanks for watching. Crunch Report airs every weekday at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific on TechCrunch.com. Believe it or not, I'll be doing this again tomorrow. See you then.